Run.
Oh, yeah, you have to toy car at the back.
Why not? There are other ways to diversify. They have.
So we're here again at Ten Market Animal Safe to bear witness to the auction off of animals, and apart from obviously seeing the animals and bearing witness to them and filming them and showing them as individuals, I want to talk to as many of the farmers and as many of the people who work here as possible. After all, these are the people who are most psychologically and economically invested in this way of life, and I want to ask them the questions I normally ask people to see if they have any different answers, to see if they can morally justify it in a different way, because these are the people that should be able to do that. And I want to see if I can reach any common ground and kind of break down any of those initial boundaries, initial barriers, and see if we can kind of establish something and maybe even plant a seed in the minds of these farmers. So let's see how that goes. I think for me, like the issue isn't necessarily just about the conditions, it's obviously the fact that these animals end up dead anyway, and from my personal opinion, even if we raise them beautifully, it's just the fact that they end up being killed in the first place.
From my point of view, we're omnivores, we eat meat.
Do you think just because we can digest something, does it make it moral? Like we could eat dog, but would that be moral to eat dogs?
I come from a science point of view. I know where we've evolved from.
Yeah, absolutely.
The other apes are most similar to us, most of them eat meat as well.
Well, I think the apes that we originally evolved from were insects and plants mostly, and then we evolved into like our early Homo sapiens, then we ate meat for necessity. But I guess the thing is, we don't have to do so anymore, like, because we have an abundance of other stuff available. There was a time undoubtedly where we had to survive, but now we don't, and I think that's why for me the issue of whether or not we should be vegan is so important, because we have the option to be vegan now.
It's not me, mate. It's not me doing chicken farming.
You are raising animals to kill them. I'm not shouting shame on you.
From my point of view, those guys over there are the same as you. From your point of view, I'm the same as
I don't agree. Because as I said before, it's not about the conditions or the welfare. It's the fact that they're ultimately killed and exploited in the first place. And you can give them a lovely, lush greenery, which you probably do.
Moral point of view that you think it's not moral to.
Well, how do you morally justify it? How do you morally justify?
Very easily.
Go on then.
Okay, I produce the animals that I eat.
Yeah.
I look after them to the best of my ability.
Yeah.
They're produced on my own farm.
Yeah.
I see them when they're born. I look after them.
Yeah.
I spend all day and all night looking after
them.
Yeah. And so morally, I feel I'm justified. People have eaten meat for millions
of years. But we've also murdered and raped each other for millions of years. Just because we've done something for a long period of time doesn't make it moral today.
Strangely enough, I've never done that.
No, exactly. Good, because it's not right,
morally,
and you acknowledge.
I don't think it's right.
There we go.
Morally, I do think it's right to eat meat.
But you think it's not moral to hurt other people because you see them as being victims. All you have to do is see the animals as victims, and you understand why it becomes an immoral act to kill them.
You're seeing them as a victim, I'm not. Yeah.
But why are they not victims in your eyes? They think and feel, right? They feel pain. They have an inherent preference to live their life like you and I do.
I don't inflict pain on them.
No, but they die. They suffer and die, and they don't want to. So even if they live a lovely life, they still
die. The most humane way.
What does the word humane mean to you, and as an objective definition?
Not having pain.
Oh, it's compassion and benevolence. But how do we compassionately kill an animal that doesn't want to die for an unnecessary reason?
Well, yeah, but you've taken that argument to a point where I can't argue against that.
Because it's objective,
though. No, but I can't argue it saying,
exactly.
Oh, that animal doesn't want to die.
Exactly.
Because I am nowhere near that point that you're coming from to be able to argue.
But objectively speaking, we know that these animals have a preference to live their life. They would rather live their life than be killed.
They wouldn't have lived if we weren't eating them. They would never have existed.
Yeah, but the fact is, that's better than being killed early. Like, you and I would...
I do say so.
Yeah, but you and I would not like to be exploited and killed at a young age just to have that experience of life.
Right. Okay, well, you just plant a field of wheat and murder that.
We don't need to do that. Listen, I don't think you're
a
bad person.
The same thing as animals.
But they're not conscious or alive. They're not sentient. They don't have a brain and a central nervous system. It takes up to 16 kilograms of plants to make 1 kilogram of animal protein.
Yeah.
So vastly more plants are used in the production of animal products than they are vegan products.
So the grass grows naturally on my farm and has done for hundreds of years.
Yeah.
So what's the problem with them eating that and producing meat out of it?
Well, the problem isn't them eating the grass. No, the problem is they're dying. We don't need to.
But
we don't. But we don't need to eat.
So we don't need to plow it up.
But at the expense of others. You're saying that it's good for the natural wildlife, but at the expense of these animals.
So my grass at home, I'll just leave it there and I'll let it just go to rack and ruin the ecosystem and not put any animals on it and not eat animals.
But you'd
rather I do that.
You can allow the wildlife to naturally flourish and allow the natural ecosystem to replenish itself and restore itself.
So in those hundreds of thousands of years ago when people started farming,
you're
saying those people were wrong?
No, because maybe it was a necessity. It's not a necessity now. I don't think you're a bad person.
It wasn't a necessity. necessity.
Okay, well
they
then
could have carried on hunting, but they have brains.
Ah, okay,
and they thought
right.
It's going
to
be easy.
But I mean, but the necessity to kind of get those calorically dense foods. Now we don't have to do that. We've got Waitrose over there and Tesco's and Sainsbury's. We don't need to do these things to animals anymore because we have an abundance of other foods we can eat.
Meat.
It is full of meat for now. It's changing. You and I can both see that there's more. Hey, listen, I don't think. Listen, I don't think what you're a bad person. I just think what you do is wrong. Okay. No, I don't. I don't think you're a bad person, sir.
I read what you guys write, and you think all farmers are bad people.
No, I don't think you're a bad person. I don't. Please, I don't think you're a bad person.
You do think I am.
No, I don't.
You do.
I think what you do is bad.
No,
I don't think people who slaughter animals are bad people. Not all of us get to choose what we do in life. But you, I presume you've been raised in a generation thing, and it's probably what you've been taught to do by your family, and that's fine. I don't think you're a bad person for it. Yeah, but you can't kill animals if you love. You can't kill them if you love them. That's the only thing, right?
Well,
you can't kill them if you love them.
Have you ever heard of euthanasia?
Yeah, but that's only because they have to die because they're suffering and in pain. These animals aren't suffering or in pain, and they don't want to die.
Yeah, you're very good at arguing, but seriously.
I'm just trying to put forward an objective reasoning.
Yeah, I know.
But I really appreciate you talking to me, by the way.
That's fine. No, it's nice to talk to you as well. I know that there are people who are not quite as nice to talk to as you.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Mentioning no.
And likely farmers as well, both sides of us can be aggressive and passionate.
No, I don't want the farmers here and the market officials here because they are threatened by you and they
of
don't know what to do.
Of course they are.
They're obviously reacting.
Yeah, absolutely. We're all passionate and we're all reacting.
It's totally the wrong thing to do.
I agree. I wholeheartedly agree with you. At least we can agree on that. Have a nice day, sir.
Okay.
Thank you for talking to me.
Okay.
Inside. But do you think that ultimately they will be killed, won't they? So do you think that that's exploitation?
Do you know that?
What's
there
that?
Could be females in there. They could be going to have cock.
But they still get killed at the end of the day, don't they?
No, they could be going to breed.
No, but they still get killed at the end of the day. There's always
you
a point where they get killed.
Moment, okay?
Yeah. If it was dogs, would you feel any differently? But no, just no. But like morally, what's the difference between a dog and eating a cow or pig? There's no right or wrong answer. It's interesting to know morally what you think.
We don't agree, and it's fine.
But yeah, but morally, what's the difference between eating a dog?
I realise what you're saying. I agree with you. However,
yeah. And would you eat a dog?
No, I wouldn't eat a dog. I don't even fucking eat meat, to be perfectly honest.
Good.
With you.
That's
there
good.
You go.
Well done. No, it's good. It's good.
Everybody has their life choices, and that's the choice that these people have made.
Yeah.
And this is the choice that you've made.
Do you think we should consider the choice of the animals in the situation, the fact that they have a preference to live and not be
but
killed?
None of them are going to die.
No, not now, but they will ultimately end up dead, yes, yeah? This is just another stage of the process before they end up dead.
If we didn't have, there would be none left. They'd all be extinct.
But we breed them into existence.
Nobody is going to look after them.
Well, there'll be sanctuaries and stuff, and naturally people who do care.
It's expensive.
Yeah, but the sanctuaries do exist. But at the end of the day, like, we've got to decide what life is better. And is it better to be born into an existence where you're born to be killed or to not be born at all? These animals aren't in pain or suffering and they're still being killed, aren't they? And I totally agree about euthanasia. And if animals are suffering, they should definitely be put down. That's the only humane thing to do. But the way that we treat animals that don't want to die isn't humane, or at least not in my opinion.
Well, no, and I don't think that... I think that people see the bad because they want to.
I agree.
I don't think all farmers treat their animals badly.
See, but ultimately they still end up dead, don't they? It doesn't matter how nicely you treat them, the fact that they will still end up with a knife across their throat or in a gas chamber, whatever way it is, it still makes it wrong.
Kill children. Some people kill humans.
And that's wrong as well, right?
Well, it is, but, you know, people abuse kids.
They do, and it's not right.
You know, and it's not right.
How many people in the world is there? 7 billion?
7.5 billion.
Okay.
Or thereabouts.
How many people eat meat?
I can't tell you. The majority of people.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make it moral just because the majority of people do something. Like the majority of people used to believe that slavery was all right. It wasn't. I mean, personally, how do you... What moral justification would you use to slaughter, the lives of these cows? Like, how do you morally justify that?
Well, I'm a Christian, and it's in the Bible to eat meat.
But in the Garden of Eden, what did Adam and Eve eat?
It didn't make a difference.
Yeah, I mean, they were vegan in the Garden of Eden. I think the reality is with religion is God has neither said that we have to or don't have to,
okay,
and
so
it becomes like a choice between the two of us.
Exactly. So,
so
it's a choice.
It becomes almost irrelevant about God because, again, it becomes personal. And again, the question is, what moral justification do we use to justify it?
You could bat that both ways, couldn't you?
You could too. But I'm just saying, God hasn't told us that we have to eat animals.
And I think that when
the Bible was written, we probably had to live. Now we don't. So I think in the eyes of God, this is my personal opinion, in the eyes of God, because we had the option between not killing his creatures or killing his creatures, morally, he'd prefer if we didn't.
There are also massive...
It's down to people's
own personal convictions, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, ultimately, but do you think that we should consider the personal convictions of the animal who has a preference to live?
Has an animal got a soul then? So how would it know?
Well, I mean, I'm not Christian, so I don't necessarily believe in what you believe in, but what I do know is that an animal is alive, they think and feel, and ultimately have a preference to live that life. That's why if we put pain upon them, they flee or try and run away like we do, because they want to live. And to me, it's not about whether they have a soul or not, it's just about the fact that they're alive. And because they're alive, they should be granted a basic moral respect to be given that chance to live, you know?
As I said, I've got nothing. Everybody's right to their own opinion. Yeah. That's yours.
Yeah.
I've got mine. Happy days.
Well, say there was a room, and in the room was a lamb, and in that room with the lamb there was Jesus and the devil. Which one would kill the lamb?
Varies.
Would they work together?
What?
Would they come together?
The Passover. That was a lamb that was killed, wasn't it?
Yeah. But say the situation now, which one would kill the lamb? So they both kill the lamb?
No, I didn't say that.
Well, I mean, which one would be engaged in the killing, Jesus or the devil? I mean, does the devil step back and let Jesus kill the innocent animal, or?
At the end of the day, it's everybody's own conviction.
But at the end of the day, when there's a victim, like if I want to bet on dog fighting, that's my personal choice. It doesn't make it moral just because I want to throw a couple of quid down on dog fighting, does it?
No, that's everybody's got their own judgments, haven't they?
But then if a morality is totally subjective, then surely rape and murder and theft and mugging and arson are totally moral because everyone has their own personal convictions.
I'm here on business.
I know. I'm putting you on the spot and I appreciate that.
I would hate to see somebody killed here.
Likewise.
Because at the end of the day...
And to be honest, I know these animals aren't dying here, but this is why we're here, because we hate to see someone being killed.
Yeah.
And that's why we're here. Yeah. It's just all you've got to ask yourself is, if we can live a healthy, happy life without harming others, why wouldn't we? And do you value your taste over the life of another? And are your taste buds worth more than the life of an animal?
Subjection, isn't it?
What do you reckon?
Depends what your judgment is.
What's your judgment tell you?
Well, I eat meat, so.
So how do you morally justify your taste preference? Because it's not about, the way I see it, you don't have to put non-human animals on the same level as humans. You can agree that humans are superior, that's fine. Or you have to acknowledge that non-human animals, their worth of life is higher than the sensory pleasure we get from taste alone. That's all we have to acknowledge. And if we can establish that the life of a sheep is worth more than our taste buds, then that's why it becomes morally disingenuous to eat them.
Good.
Something to think about, right? Food for thought, pardon the pun.
Yeah. Literally.
Literally, pardon the pun, yeah.